It is Wednesday, April the 13th, 2022. Currently nine pennants. That's where we're at now. Nine pennants. That's where this show is. Folks, it is Wednesday, April the 13th, 2022. Currently 10 minutes past the 9 o'clock hour. Here we go. Another night on the internet. I am James. You are you. And we are here.
You're listening to the highest internet radio station in the game. Turn this up. Everything is A-OK. This is hot.
Hello, Montreal, and welcome to Sex City. Right all the way from the Greek islands, this is Ricky Tzatziki, and we are playing nothing but the greatest hits right here on At Home with James. Let's party, let's have a great time, and let the music run through your veins, because James McGee is the number one party boy in this sex city. So let's dance tonight and get ready to make some love. This is At Home with James.
Yeah, this is At Home with James, and that was the sweet stylings and sounds of Ricky Tzatziki. If you were not here last Wednesday, allow me to fill you in on what is going on and why this is going on. As some of you may or may not know, Andy Assaf retired from his duties as technical director on Wednesdays. Filling in for him was Dimitri Kyres, who promptly announced that these are the new Wednesdays on At Home with James. He has taken over some type of persona as a radio DJ, and it sounds like he has hired someone named Ricky Tzatziki to become, I guess, our version of Mix 96, currently known as Virgin 96's MC Mario, famous DJ and sleazeball. Well, this is the new Wednesdays. We are here. We are live. This is in living color, all across the information superhighway that the cool kids called the internet in the mid-90s. What is going on tonight? Well, much later on, the aforementioned Dimitri Kyres is going to be here. Also, a little bit later on, is going to be a true legend of the at-home universe. Of course, we're talking about Saima Ahmed, who's going to help me understand what it means to have fun and how a guy like me can have fun. I won't get into it too much right now because we've got our first guest on tap. The reason this show is starting late is because this person was on the toilet. Please welcome our friend, your friend, and my friend. Of course, we're talking about Racquel Belmonte.
Welcome to my house. Baby, take control now. We can't even scroll now. We don't have to go out. Welcome to my house.
I fucking love the new Wednesday thing, James. Yeah. Oh my God.
I'm still trying to get used to it, right? There's a lot of sound bites and stingers that come in. I'm used to just doing intros and then saying, how's it going? How are you? Thanks for being here. Now we're getting the music of Flow Rider.
Yeah, Flow Rider.
I'm not going to say it like that.
Okay, well, maybe it's time to try something new. You should change with the show.
This is the thing, Racquel. It's very hard for me to change with the times. I get settled in my ways. I get comfortable and, dare I say, complacent. It's just a bubble that I like being in. And then before you know it, the sounds of Flow Rider, AKA, as you would put it, Flow Rida.
Yeah.
I'm seeping into my world and I'm not quite sure what to think. It throws me off course just a little bit.
Okay. Well, I hope that one day you can adjust, you know, nicely. Like one of like my flowers, not my flowers. Fuck. My plants that I bought new pots for. Hopefully they adjust.
This makes me feel better. This makes me feel better about saying pennants instead of minutes.
Oh my God.
At the top of the show.
James, that was the best joke you've ever made on this show. Hands down, 10 out of 10. Pennants, we stand.
Not even a joke, just a flub of the words. And can I tell you something, Racquel, as someone who uses their voice for a living, perhaps you can relate. Anytime I botch my verbiage, I'm rattled for the rest of the show.
Oh, yeah.
I have a very hard time. My body is hot right now, and it's because of that.
This is the best. I'm having the best time.
Yeah, after multiple appearances, you finally unlocked having the best time on this show.
On Wednesdays. Monday's not a problem.
The kids love you. The kids love you. Now things have changed.
Things are changing.
Since you were last here on Wednesdays. Yeah. Tonight we've got Ricky Tadziki in the booth. I think Dimitri's creeping around somewhere. This is a big difference between what you're used to on Wednesdays, which includes Andy Assaf.
Yeah, and you two bully me until I leave the show.
Well, I don't recall ever bullying you.
Both assholes.
I think that there was some contention between you and Andy, and I was in the middle trying to build a bridge between the both of you. And I think maybe you misinterpreted it. But that's neither here nor there.
Neither here nor there. Look how happy we are now. This was it. This was always it.
Now, coming in from the chat, someone wants to know if you're drinking a goblet of red wine.
Yeah, man, I put way too much in there. I haven't had a drink in a really long time.
Can we see this?
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Oh,
right. Man. Now, how long, Racquel, will that take to get you inebriated, or some might say tipsy?
Like two of these. I don't know. I filled this pretty high. Two of these. I ate pasta tonight.
Okay. Yeah. So you're balancing out with some carbs.
Hell yeah, I am.
Well, Racquel, you know, it's been a while, as the lead singer Aaron Lewis of Stained once said.
That was beautiful.
Since you've been here, thank you so much, right? You were here last week when we had the team building night. That was last week, right?
It
feels like it's been longer than it has been.
It feels like that was a month ago.
Mm-hmm.
I'd
like to imagine that we learned a lot of lessons that night. We're going to be able to launch in tonight feeling positive, feeling together, and just feeling united as one.
Yes. Okay. What are we doing? Ask me anything. Let's do something.
All right.
I'm all amped now.
Are you sure you're not a little tipsy already?
James, no. What? How? Look, my cheeks aren't even red.
Well, I think it was first your use of the rock and roll devil horns.
You don't like when I do it?
Followed by, okay, F it. What are we doing? Right? Racquel, let us know. What's been going on in your life in the past week?
James, so many things. Thank you for asking. My mom sent me a package yesterday, a care package, if you will.
What's your mom's name?
Gilda. Like Gilda, but with the soft G.
Yeah. There's nothing soft about that G.
Oh, I hate
Gilda,
that.
No, there's nothing soft about that G.
Anyways, Gilda sent me a care package of all my favorite snacks, and it was fantastic. And one of the things that was in there, my niece got me a little Easter gift. My family celebrates Easter. It's a whole thing. But I got a Kinder Surprise. Mm-hmm. And I love Kinder Surprise. You like Kinder Surprise? How are we feeling about it?
I like them when I was eight.
Exactly. Every time!
The kids love them. I enjoyed them when I was a kid that got excited about eating candy.
Well, I'm a dumb fucking adult.
Racquel, you're not a DFA. You are not a DFA. You're an adult who enjoys sweets.
And
that sound effect was specifically for you, Racquel.
I deserve that because I made you guys wait. Mm-hmm. But wait, this all comes together so beautifully. Mm-hmm. So there was the Kinder Surprise. I had half of the Kinder Surprise chocolate. James, almost instantly, I had a stomach cramp. I was like, fuck off. So then I ate an edible and I'm like, okay, this is going to fix everything. But then I got so high that I ate the bit. My mom got me mini eggs because they're my favorite chocolate.
Now, when we say mini eggs, we're talking about the shell encrusted chocolates.
Yes. Not the fucking goop chocolate.
You're disparaging the Cadbury cream egg.
Yeah, I hate those. I think those are stupid. They shouldn't exist.
Of all the three, I want to do kind of a top three here. So it sounds like, are the Cadbury mini eggs your number one? Or is Kinder Surprise your number one?
Are we talking snacks in the box or my favorite snacks? Because it's different.
We're talking about the three very notable Easter chocolates. So we've got the Cadbury cream egg, which I suspect would be at the bottom of the list.
I got to ask. Sorry, I need clarification because I want to give you the best response I can give you. Yeah. You mean Easter chocolates in general or Easter chocolates that were in my box?
In general.
In general. Okay, that changes everything. Yeah, mini eggs are always number one.
Right. Then it would be the Kinder Surprise.
Yeah.
The chocolate feels very secondary to the toy on the inside.
And the toy is so fun. They're so stupid now, by the way. Mine was pretty sick, but they're dumb now. I don't want a fucking puzzle. Now,
what did you, okay, a nerd. So you got a puzzle? I thought it was going to be maybe a sticker of a bear.
Oh, no. I got an Elsa figurine. That's what I wanted to show you.
Who's that?
Are you fucking kidding me? Elsa? From Elsa and Anna from Frozen? Frozen 1 and Frozen 2?
Well, Let it go again, much
into
like
the unknown?
Much like Easter chocolate, I left the children's movies in the past.
Cool.
All right, the reviews are in for Elsa. What was it? Orchid?
What?
Is that what you said? Elsa and Orchid?
Elsa and Anna, her little sister.
From the film Frozen?
The hit film Frozen.
Yeah, that's fine. I don't think that I was really their target demographic.
I wasn't either, but I still got my eyes on it a bunch
of times.
Can
I tell you something, Racquel? I did not grow up watching a lot of Disney films.
Okay, that's super fair. My mom was a Disney adult. How pathetic is that? Then I bullied her
Gilda
out of it.
Gilda
so
was
she's
a
not
Disney
anymore.
Adult?
Oh, fuck. I forgot I told you her name. Yes, yeah. She was. Me and my brothers, our whole like room had those Disney plates and like, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
That's nice. It feels like, you know, you grew up in a fun environment, right? The only thing we had on our wall growing up in my home was a framed picture of a cat inside a pot of spaghetti.
That's
and the
cute.
cat was covered in spaghetti. It's currently in my washroom now.
That's cool. And that's nice.
I want to say, I don't know what the hell that sound clip was.
I loved it.
Sounded it. Like someone, that may have been someone outside my window. Oh.
Nerd alert.
Nerd alert. Now, that one, I don't want to project here, Racquel. That one, I believe it may have been for you.
I'm not a nerd. I think I'm like the most opposite of a nerd. Listen, I can't say too much about what.
You're all nerdy about something. We don't want to get you in trouble with any of your fans or employers, so we're gonna stay away from it. Let's circle back to the Easter chocolate, right?
Fine, yes.
Talk about Easter a little bit. I want to tell you something.
Tell me
again,
everything.
I feel like we've been teetering on contention since this segment started.
What does contention mean? Sorry, I wanted to ask before and I pretended I knew what it meant, yeah. But I don't think I had it right. What does contention mean?
The way that I'm using it, it's like there's a slight dusting that there might be some arguing or tension between us right now.
Oh,
there's just a little, yeah, there we go, correct, yeah.
I'm sorry. Maybe that's the energy I brought in.
No, Racquel, if anything, I'm taking over from where Andy left off on Wednesdays. Now, in the name of contention, I want to let you know that I very much enjoy the Cadbury cream egg. I like that cream.
Maybe that's where the underlying contention is. Because I like that cream. Just kind of pieced itself together in my head.
Yeah, that's
disgusting.
Also, it's a new t-shirt I'm coming out with. It's going to be a line of merch for the show. It's got my face and then I like that cream.
Welcome to the cum zone.
Oh!
That slogan, that's Andy's upcoming shirt for the show.
Oh my God, my whole body's in shock right now.
Yeah, you know, I
have tears coming out of
I dealt with a lot of these stingers and sound effects last week. The only thing that bothers me most about that one is that there's a fart noise after.
Yeah, but it's like, depending on how you interpret it, it could have been anything. Oh, yeah. Oh, I want to die. Oh,
I like
my
that you're
God.
You're waving it away like you can smell a fart, by the way.
Look how sweaty I am now.
Racquel, you look great.
Thanks. I know. Well, no, that was rude. I didn't mean to say that either. Thank you. Well, anyways, you're a cream boy. You like cream eggs.
I never said I was a cream boy. I said I like that cream. I'm a boy who likes that cream.
Oh, I thought the cum zone thing was going to play again.
Coming in from the chat is a longtime viewer who's back tonight. Farm Boy says, quote, gotta say, the fart noise is growing on me.
Oh, hell yeah.
Kids love it.
Kids
now,
love
Racquel,
it. Yeah.
Can I ask you now off the top?
Oh my God.
Now, Racquel, you mentioned that your family does Easter. Is it a holiday that you care about at all?
Not at all. My mom on Good Friday, I don't know why I did that. It's called Good Friday to some people. She texts me every Good Friday and says, Racquel, don't forget to eat meat. And spitefully, I'll go eat meat. I'm not Catholic anymore.
No, wait, is she saying don't forget to eat meat or to not eat meat?
What did I say? Because I said, meant don't forget to eat meat.
Yeah, exactly. She don't probably wants meat. You to... Have you a nice plate of fish sticks or something like that?
Yeah, but instead I do eat meat. Don't know. I don't care. I don't give a fuck.
Okay, well, let's so dig in. What about your old man? Does he eat meat on Good Friday or is he just eating fish?
My dad doesn't care. He's Catholic, but he doesn't like he'll be like, gee, I don't understand why we're doing this. My dad has like a New York accent, but isn't from there. It makes no sense. And he, I don't know, the more un-Catholic I became, he kind of followed suit.
Suit.
Fuck me. I love that. I don't know if that's like a door, but whatever it is.
That I believe was the correct noise sound effect for me correcting whether it was sweet or suit.
I have like good noise. So my dad doesn't care anymore, but I think because my mom, they don't give a shit. Sorry, I'm an idiot. My middle brother doesn't eat meat. My little brother doesn't care.
Okay. Now when everyone's together at home during the Easter season, are you guys all having dinner together? Is there some type of tradition that includes not only the chocolate and things of that nature, but like a specific series of family meals?
I just had the best idea ever. Yes, James, I'm so glad you asked. Yes, every year on both sides of the family. Okay, so I have my mom's side of the family on one Easter. Wait, how many Easter days? There's Sunday and Monday? Fuck me.
Yeah, there's usually, it's kind of like a 4-day event, right? You've got Good Friday, then there's the Easter Monday, and then the weekend can be spent celebrating.
Okay, what is Palm Sunday?
That's probably, who cares? That's probably the Sunday.
Oh, I'll talk to my mom after. Anyways, sure. Okay, so my mom's side of the family, she has a huge family. Like there's 17 grandchildren.
How many NZOs do you have?
My mom has five brothers and sisters.
Each?
No, I'm an idiot. No, there's six of them. Five of them? Anyway, I was right. It was five or six of them. Anyways, they all have, a lot of them are much older, so they have kids and then they've had kids. So anyways, there's a bunch of us. There's like 17 of us. So we do a massive Easter egg hunt and they're good. They put money in the eggs and I still get to participate as an adult.
Yeah. Now I think that's a fun way for adults to celebrate Easter, right? I did not grow up in a particularly religious household at all. Easter stopped being a thing in my home once we stopped being youngsters. I think for my mother, it was, well, we don't have to buy the kids chocolate anymore because they can just go to the corner store and buy a Kit Kat bar if they want to.
I love that logic, and I will do that when I am a mother, if I ever am.
Well, Racquel, let's get into it. Would you like to be a mother?
I don't know. The more I used to want to be, and now I'm like, nah, let's just keep my IUD in forever.
Okay.
That's the thing that keeps me...
Well, Racquel, we've got a surprise for you.
Not again. Fuck. Oh, no.
We want you to go to your fridge and open it now. There's a baby in there.
No, there's
babies in there.
The kids want me to go. I'll go. I can't do it. No, well,
Racquel, let's talk about this, right? I love
I don't know if that was a baby, but were you a baby?
Now, you have to. See, this is where I'm starting to get bothered that I'm adapting to all these noises.
No, you should. You're adjusting. This is the new you, James. This is the new Wednesday night at home with James. What's the show called?
Yeah, you and everyone else.
Anyways, do I want a baby? Not the one that's in my fridge.
Well, hold on. Let's all, Racquel, just take a breath, right? Have another sip.
You're judging me.
I'm not judging. What I want to do is I like to get personal on this show. This can be a show.
Yeah, apparently.
This is a show that can be really silly and wacky and weird. But I'm curious to know, in the name of Easter and hypotheticals, how would you celebrate Easter if you had a child or a couple kids?
Do I have a husband?
Would you?
I'd rather a husband than a kid.
Well, why not both?
Okay, fine. My husband's hot for the context of this. Yeah, he's so hot.
He's a hot guy named Giuliano.
Oh, like G-I-U, like Giuliano?
No, I was thinking J-U-L-I-A-N-O.
Okay, I have a problem with the way that's spelled, but that's
okay,
fine.
Well, we can spell it G-U-I-L-I-A-N-O.
No, I'll call him Juju. Oh, I'm in love with Giuliano. Okay,
wait, hold
perfect.
On, you're going to call him Juju?
Juju, my baby.
Well, I'm
Juju.
Glad Dave's not here for this one.
Okay, no, yeah. no, that's
Raquel,
not.
Raquel, just take a sip of wine. Let's just relax. Now, you're spending Easter with your two kids and your husband,
Why
Giuliano.
Do I have two?
Okay, do you want three?
No,
four?
No, I want twins. That's fine.
You've got twins.
Yeah.
You're spending it with your husband, Giuliano, aka Juju.
No, we're not doing that anymore.
How are you celebrating Easter?
Well, my husband and I are obviously going to wake up and fuck. That's right. And then.
Now, what time are you waking up?
Oh, like 11 a.m. I'm sleeping in. I don't wake up early for anybody.
So is he, apparently.
Yeah, that's fine. And our kids are going to be cool. Like, they're going to wake up late too. Like, oh shit, what time is it? I'm like, that's okay.
How old are your kids in this scenario?
These two.
Are like, okay, so they're
three.
Two and they're...
No, I don't know. Like, old enough to enjoy something.
In this scenario, your kids are two and they already have the voice of a longtime smoker.
Okay, but that's what I sounded like when I was two. So to be fair,
all right.
It makes sense.
So you guys now, are you guys waking up and making love and then hiding the Easter eggs?
I'm not doing anything like for the whole thing. I'm just going right. to, yeah, my husband is going to be perfect. And he's going to be like, babe, you're so busy all the time and you're so hot and tired. Why don't you just like lay down here? I'm going to hide all the eggs. You just like, I'll wake you up when the kids are done. And so, I'm going to make breakfast because I love you. And then we'll fuck again. And then he leaves. He does all. No, this guy's perfect. I'm obsessed with him. So he's going to do everything. He's going to set up the house. The mini eggs.
Now, can I, at the risk of interjecting here and backtracking, is he doing everything during the coitus as well?
Yeah, he's putting the eggs together. So we're going to put money in our eggs.
Wait, hold on. Raquel, do you know what coitus means?
Sex.
Okay.
I'm not an idiot. I'm not a nerd, James.
I just wanted to check
in. This guy fucks.
Wait, you're saying that he's putting the eggs together while you guys are making love?
Yeah. How do we want to do this? Okay. No, that makes sense. So gross.
Be as specific as you like.
If he's hitting it this way.
Yeah, we get it.
He can put him together on my back.
Yeah, he can even eat his breakfast back there. Put the plate
down.
No,
we're having breakfast as a family.
Oh, I understand.
That's the whole thing. He's going to make, I'm sweating. He's going to make.
Yeah, I thought he was going to have his workstation here and then the breakfast plate there so he can go back and then put the eggs together, you know.
Maybe, I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. It's so early to tell. Yeah, so we're going to put money in the eggs and then. He's going to be like, okay, I'm going to be like, oh, I'm so well rested and I look perfect in the morning. And I'm going to come out with like my
I believe
like,
the way that you put it was hot and tired.
Hot and tired. But now I'm not tired. I'm just hot. So I'm going to come out with my robe. I'm like, oh, did you guys love Easter? My kids are going to be like, oh, mommy, we love you. Thank you for everything. I'll take credit for all of it. My husband can't hear shit because he's making pancakes with mini eggs instead of chocolate chips. Oh, that's good. And then he goes, babe, take your Loctaid and try this. Because if I don't, we all know what's going to happen.
Giuliano is very thoughtful. Yeah, you know, that's why you need the Loctaid, Raquel.
Because then it's just going to be a mess.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Yeah. I felt that one. That one just like went inside my body.
What did you think of that one?
I need a minute.
Take a second.
Oh my God.
Okay, Raquel, I want you to take a second, folks. If you're tuned in right now, this is Raquel. I'm James. You're watching At Home with James, or as Raquel put it, Wednesdays at Home with James.
I said at home.
I have to be honest. No show this Friday. I'll be live on stage with friends, but we will be back this upcoming Monday. We'll have an Easter episode. Isn't that exciting? Raquel, how do you feel? You're back. You're feeling good.
I'm so good. It's like that never happened. Oh, I'm thinking about it again. Anyways, but then my husband's going to be like, Raquel, I got you. Easter's not just for the kids.
Yeah.
I got you something too.
Okay. Well, that's nice. Now, what do you think he got you? Is it a Kinder surprise? Is it something of the sort?
It's a giant, like a big Kinder surprise. And inside is a bunch of money. And I'll be like, babe, I make my own money. In fact, I make more money than you, you idiot. And he's like, ha, you're right. Let's go out for, I don't know. Let's go out. Oh, no. Oh, what do I want to do with the money? A boob job.
Okay.
Yeah, because my kids have probably fucked up my tits. There it is. That's the right answer.
Okay. So your husband, Giuliano, AKA Juju, he has given you an enormous Kinder surprise full of money. You begin by declining the money, but then you decide to go out, but then rescind that and say, I'm going to spend it on breast augmentation.
Yeah. He'll be like, no, it's for a nice dinner. I'm like, I'll pay for a nice dinner. You can pay for new tits for me and the ones that I talked about on the show last week. I'm not going to bring it up again. I think I was gross enough.
You did.
I'm over it. No, yeah. You know, the specifics.
Yeah. I remember. Yeah. The heart-shaped nipples. I remember. Excuse me. The areolas. I want to make it clear that I recognize that female anatomy is a little bit different and I'm aware that it's not all just that. There we go. Not just all nipple.
Yeah. That was my impression of the kids.
Yeah.
I guess they didn't care. But anyways, yeah. So, oh no.
Raquel, you ate some of that big Kinder surprise, didn't you, without the lactate?
Yeah, just the one I took wasn't enough. That's what I learned yesterday.
Yeah.
But anyways. Okay.
So how do you round out this lovely Easter day with your kids and your husband? So you've decided you're going to go out for a dinner and you can buy your own.
We're not going for dinner. Okay. I'm using that money for boobs. So
do you go get a boob job on Easter?
No, I'll spend Easter with my kids. I'll do the boob job next week. Cause I still want to be with my family. Cause I still I don't celebrate the like religious portion, but I still like getting fucked up with my family. Okay. Why am I swearing so much? Who am I? What did I
think
even,
it's
like?
I think it's the wine talk.
I'm not drunk.
Now in this scenario, are you spending Easter with your husband, kids, as well as your immediates?
Yeah. So, oh God, who's going to even be alive at this point? We'll go to my aunt's house. She has a huge house. So we'll go there. They'll do an Easter egg hunt with the kids. Mm-hmm. I'll be with my husband and like my cousins and everybody else. And we're going to have fun. And my husband will be like, babe, you drink as much as you want because I love to drive.
Okay. So he's the designated driving dad.
Yeah. This guy's perfect.
Yeah.
I'm obsessed with him.
Yeah. Now, how does the night end?
My kids will, my husband will put my kids to bed. We're going to go home. Sorry. I'm going so out of order. We're going to go home.
It's okay. It's okay.
Everyone's going to be full and happy and excited. We got leftovers. That's the best part of Easter for me is when my aunts give me food to take home. Me and my husband are going to get fucking stoned. We're going to eat in bed while our kids are asleep. And then we're going to Railtown, baby.
Okay. So you're going to eat in bed. Then you're going to go to Railtown. Are you not worried that that's going to cause maybe like a rumbling?
I feel like the rumbling's been, whatever happens, happens. At
okay.
This
so
point.
It's done at that point. It's done. Want to be clear, everyone watching, I'm not in charge of these sounds. I truly, this is why it's important for me, folks, that you see when I'm hosting. I gesticulate a lot. I move my hands. I'm over here. I'm clicking the pen. I'm not making these noises. I don't have a soundboard. Raquel, so that's the end of your hypothetical Easter with your kids, your family, and of course your husband, Giuliano.
Yeah, he's the best. Yeah. That's it. That's Easter.
So it begins with passion and it ends with passion.
Yeah. I think I'm going to be a bad mom.
Yeah. I want us to think about this. You've spent Easter talking about getting a boob job. neglecting your family to have sexual intercourse three times. You got drunk at dinner to the point that your husband had to drive home. Then you got stoned and ate in bed.
Yeah. See, that sounds amazing to me, but a mother? Actually, that'd be fun too. Are you kidding me?
Well, it'll give your kids something to talk about with their therapist when they grow up. There you go. Raquel, we're going to talk soon. That's it. Raquel, there's 20 minutes left in the show.
I swore for 15 of those minutes. Why didn't you tell me to do something conducive?
Raquel, here's the thing. I'm not someone that's going to stifle people's creativity, and this is why we have you on the show. If it was, remember the old days when you'd send apologies after, right? Those days are gone because you're comfortable. This means that we're comfortable together on the show.
Yeah, that's fine.
Is everything okay?
Yeah, no, it's good. I'm good. I'm happy.
Look, you'll be here next week.
Yeah, that's what they all say.
Well, you've been here every week since. Look, I'm not going to. Raquel, thanks so much for being here. I want you to enjoy the rest of your glass of wine and the glasses that follow. And I want to wish you a fantastic Easter weekend.
Before I go, can I show you something? You said glasses, and this, look what I bought. And I forgot I had bought it because I was very high. I need to chill with the drugs. But check out what I got. And they came yesterday. And I was like, when did I order these?
Okay, so you're ready for the summer. You got nothing but love in your eyes.
And their heart. Oh, shit. I can't. Oh, fuck. God damn it. Wait. You know what? Fuck it. Pretend I never did that. Pretend that never happened. Cut it from this shit.
We'll scrub it from the episode once we upload it to the bank. Raquel, thanks so much for being here and have a good rest of the night, okay?
Bye. I love you.
I love you too. Everybody, let's reflection and beauty. And that's Jamie coming up. Let's party and we're welcoming the beautiful love. Let's go. Yeah. As Raquel signed off and I reciprocated that message of I love you, it occurred to me that's the first time I've said that to a woman in probably 4 years. Anyways, let's welcome our next woman to tonight's show. She is a pillar of this program. <She's welcome. laughs> Please welcome Saima Ahmed to the show. I'm looking like
money. Make it rain on. Hi James, how are you?
Hey Saima, I'm feeling very, very good tonight. How about you?
Good. Can I ask, do you cut your mom? I guess you're not counting your mom, or you don't tell your mom you love her?
I would say that in my family, exchanging the words I love you to each other, this is all of us, it's not something that we do, even though we all do love each other and we're a family that get along very well. We're not a family that exchanges the words often.
Okay.
But I do love, I love my mother, I love my sister, I love my family, but it's not a thing that we say often.
Okay.
And I think objectively, had I said, except for my mother in that little joke prior, that would have sounded sadder than the original version.
I think so too.
There we go. Okay. So we're getting a no from Raquel as she eats what looks to be a bowl of food off air. Yep. It's a bowl of food. All right. So Saima, how's your week treating you?
Not bad, not bad. I can't believe it's already Wednesday. But right. Yeah, pretty good. How are you?
I'm doing well. Did you enjoy yesterday's lovely day?
No, well, kind of. I wanted to go for a jog, but I ended up working. And then I came home and I was tired.
Now, for people who don't know, you work at?
I'm doing my PhD. So I work at a hospital. And sometimes I stay late because I have to meet with my patients.
Right. Now, the reason that I'm bringing you here today is that yesterday I had a great time. Dare I say that I had fun? I was sitting at home.
You had fun.
I had fun.
Okay.
And I'll get to that in a second. I was looking out my window and I thought, I have to get outside. It was the nicest day of the year so far, right? I think we can all agree on that. I bought a cold coffee from a newly opened Mr. Puff's in St. Henry.
Where?
Right downstairs from my apartment.
Oh my God. Look at you, James.
Yeah. I'd like to think that I was the catalyst of the gentrification of St. Henry, but I won't get into that. I bought their Mr. Puff's Nescafe Frappe, took a sip and thought, okay, my taste went from improving to, regressing somehow. I improved and regressed, but I thought I'm gonna try to have a nice time. I was wearing shorts. I took a walk along the Lachine Canal. I did what I call the little tour de l'île, the tour of the island. Then along the water, I saw these two big geese, and I thought, this is great. I'm seeing some geese. The sun was caressing my skin. And then I got home, and I thought, I was so overwhelmed. And I thought, I don't understand this feeling that I've got going on inside of me. And it was precious. It was a feeling of excitement and joy. And then I thought, this has been lacking in my life. And moreover, there we go. That indicates correct. It has been lacking in my life, the way that vitamin D, people have vitamin D deficiencies. I feel like I have a vitamin F deficiency. The F is for fun. Now, a couple weeks ago, someone said, oh, come on. You have fun. You perform and you do all these shows. And I was like, yeah, but that feels more like projects and, dare I say, my way of living. Saima, I don't think I have any fun and I don't know what to do for fun. That's why I wanted to bring you on the show, because I think that you know how to have fun. Now, I'm thrusting this on you out of the blue.
I feel like I do know how to have fun, but I will say I saw you have fun recently. This sounds weird. But we went bowling and I think you had fun.
Okay. Yeah. We're pulling the curtains back here for the people that are watching who may not be familiar with you and I, right? Simon, would you like to explain what this event was?
It was for my birthday and I invited my friends to go bowling because I think it's a fun activity to do with people.
Yes.
And I had fun and I think you had fun and other people as well also had fun.
I would agree. I did have fun. Because I expected when you invited everyone to go bowling, I thought this is going to be a cool bowling alley that featured, you know, the lights off with some type of glow in the dark.
I will admit, I also thought it would be a cool bowling alley that had the lights off.
Yeah.
Because I've been there before and the lights have always been off.
And this is what I was thinking. I thought there was going to be like, we talked about him earlier, the aforementioned Flow Rider. I thought it was going to be music like that. The welcome to my house, baby, come on over. Welcome to my house, baby, take control now. We can't. Yeah, that's the fart remix. Now, and then I got there and I was pleasantly surprised that it felt like a bowling alley that was tailor-made for lowlives. And I felt very welcomed in that
arena. I don't know what that says about you, James.
Well, I feel like that I fit in places that would feature video lotto terminals, classic rock music, old guys, right? I don't feel that I am for today's youth. So I feel like, there we go. So it is correct, accurate. So when I saw the locale that we were in, I thought, this is really exciting. I feel comfortable.
Well, you can always go back bowling if you want to have fun. You can go solo. Maybe you can join a bowling league and then go every week.
Now that feels unlikely that I could join a bowling league. I don't think I'm a good enough bowler for that sort of thing.
I will say I don't remember your bowling, but I remember other people impressed me and you were not in my memory of being an impressive bowler. No offense.
Well, I will say that we played many, many frames. I won the first frame handily.
Oh, okay. See, yeah. I don't remember this. I was too busy
specializing. And then after that, I stopped trying that hard.
Okay.
My first bowl was a strike.
Oh, there you go. So you're a solid bowler.
But here's the thing, right? It was so unimpressive that you didn't even notice, even though I won, right? So maybe this stands to say that I wasn't having enough fun. I wasn't saying, woo, yippee, I love it. You know, I could have been celebrating to indicate to everyone, I'm winning. Everyone look at me, I'm winning, right?
I feel like that's not your style.
Well, exactly, right? So, okay, so you're saying that maybe I could spend more time bowling. Saima, when you look at me, what else do you think I could be doing for fun? Or maybe what do I do for fun that I don't even know about?
Well, you seem to enjoy going outside when the weather is nice. I feel like you like wearing shorts for some reason. I don't know.
Okay, so on the list of things that I like doing for fun, one of them includes wearing shorts.
Well, I don't know. It wasn't even it was nice outside, but it wasn't like super hot. I'm amazed you wore shorts, but if it makes you happy and it's fun for you, wear shorts.
Yeah, as Cheryl Crow once said, if it makes you happy, it can't be that bad.
There you go. But here's my thing, express yourself. So wear whatever you want. That could be fun. I have fun with clothes. You can also have fun with your clothes.
Yeah, I would say that I have the most fun with my clothes during the early spring weeks as well as fall. Like if I could be wearing this outfit, my little black pants, my spring jacket. That's when I was saying to someone earlier today, that's when I'm at my happiest.
That's like a quintessential. When I think of James, I think of like this look. I think of like t-shirt, plaid button up style, a zip up hoodie, that hat, black, like Dickies style pants and like Vans.
Yeah, that is essentially it, right? I love wearing black pants. I like a nice fitted pair of chinos. Those are my favorite types of pants to wear. But again, now it's just like, I feel like we're digging myself the hole even deeper. Where it's like James is in his comfort zone. He doesn't like wearing fedoras or berets and his hat options.
Well, like don't go for the fedora.
Okay.
The beret, maybe it could, I like a beret, but that's how, I don't know if it's fun, but that's how I express myself.
So yeah. Now see, I think you pull off a beret now.
Yeah.
What else do you think I could be doing for fun, right? Summer's right around the corner. The best of spring is here in only a couple days.
Maybe like other activities, I guess. I don't know. James, maybe like go on dates. You're a single guy. You can go on dates, bring girls to like restaurants. I feel like this is a potential fun.
Yeah. Date, that's a thing people do for fun, right? A date. They're like, hey, why don't you come to a restaurant with me?
Yeah, this is what I've learned is that you're not supposed to go to a restaurant right away.
Okay.
That's third date thing.
Yeah. Now I would say that if I had it my way, the first date would maybe be, do you want to get a coffee and sit in the park?
That's nice. That's a fun date.
Yeah. That's what I call a James McGee classic.
Yeah. That could be a fun date for you. There
you go. Baba Booey. There we go. So I don't know what that means, but I think it means accurate. Okay. So you're saying maybe I could go on some dates for fun.
Yeah, you could travel. Are you into traveling?
Yeah, I would say that I haven't traveled in many, many years. Last time I was on an aeroplane was 2014.
Where were you going?
I went to Chicago.
Oh, mm-hmm. Wait, have you ever been outside of North America?
Yes.
Where? When?
I've been to France. I've been to Belgium. I've been to Sweden. I've been to Denmark. I was in Spain briefly.
I do not know this.
You better believe it.
James, this is a whole other side of you. This seems right? Like a fun side of you. Did you enjoy all these travel, travel things?
Yeah, I did. I thought it was a very pleasant experience. It was very pleasant and positive.
Were you solo? If you don't mind me asking, was this alone?
No, I was not solo. I was with a friend of mine.
Okay. Mm-hmm. There you go. This seems like a fun idea.
Right? Now, Saima, let's call it as it is here. You saw me. You thought this is not an international traveler. But this is not a guy who would spend his money on going somewhere exquisite.
Maybe. I will say. Maybe I did, perhaps.
Look, I want to be honest here. I'm not bothered by that, right? And this has happened to us before, right? At the we were at a Christmas party recently, and I showed up not wearing this. I was wearing a cardigan, and you asked me, quote, are you just coming from a wedding?
Okay, I feel like I've said this story many times. It's only because I once invited you to my house for Thanksgiving and I told you to dress nicely and you wore like a hoodie. You were wearing
this. I wore the exact same clothes that you saw me wearing the day before and I had spilled a pie all over myself.
Exactly.
All right.
And you wearing like a cardigan is the, I was like, wow, this is like, you look nice, James.
Yeah,
was
some effort. Okay. So you're saying with all these kind of discoveries here that there is potential for me to maybe have more types of fun than you would have given me credit for initially.
Yes. I'm trying to think of other things you could do for fun. I feel like you like listening to classic rock music.
Yeah, I do love that.
Ooh, maybe you could go. Do they have those like old school diners where you can like put money in and then you pick your song?
Oh, see that now they have those at the Green Spot, but they're just for show. They're decor. Mm-hmm. They no longer work. But I would love to go to a place that's got a jukebox and I could impose my music on all the people.
Do you enjoy dancing?
I wouldn't say that I enjoy doing it. Once in a while, I will cut a rug in my own home to some particular songs. I'll boogie a little bit in my own home.
I see, this is a whole new side of you, James. I didn't know this.
Right, this is my move.
Well, maybe practice on, maybe like watch some YouTube videos.
What am I gonna do?
Oh, maybe you could start a TikTok account where you dance.
Now, yeah, this is something you've talked to me about before. You're saying that I should start TikTok. I think I don't know if I'm the voice for the youth.
What makes you say that?
Well, TikTok's for the youngsters, I feel.
I feel like the theme of this is you stop yourself from having fun, James.
Oh, let me write that down. I like that. James, you stop yourself from having fun. Well, you heard that sound effect. It's a money idea.
There you go. So yeah, why not? And there's older people on TikTok too. And I'm not saying you're necessarily old. I'm saying there's people of all ages on TikTok. Mm-hmm.
Well, look, we'll call it as it is. I'm 34 years old. This September, I share a birthday with Racquel Belmonte, September 5th. Ooh.
Fun.
I'm born in the year of 1987. Now, you know, I would say that that while I would not call 34 going on 35 old, it's not a hip age, right? But I've never been one to desire the feeling of being hip, right? I think most people might look at me and go, this guy's, I don't know, 29, 30.
Well, I was going to say, you look like you're in your 20s.
There we go. You know, I have the disposition of an old man. I've got the face of someone in their 20s and the body of a 14-year-old.
Look, maybe this could be, if you ever go on like dating apps, this could be your like tagline or something.
Okay. Well, let me ask you this, Saima. If you came across someone with that biography, what would your reaction be? You delete the app.
Maybe. But I feel like we're how do I say this? I don't mean this in a mean way, but like we're not each other's cup of tea in that aspect. So I feel like maybe to a girl to whom, who
yeah,
there might be a girl to whom this appeals to.
Right. Yeah. Now, what type of woman do you think that would appeal to?
I'm not to judge.
Aren't you?
Someone who enjoys classic rock and a young looking person. I'm not sure. Someone who.
Yeah. So a cougar is what you're basically outlining.
Yeah. Here. There you go.
So, yeah. A lady named Susan or Linda or Kathleen or Carol, Sheila.
There you go. I'm sure there has to be.
So for fun, you're saying that I get on a dating app where it's a younger men looking for cougars.
Yes.
But I don't know if that's specifically something that I'm... How did this turn into a dating tip segment? I was looking for fun.
I don't know.
I'm looking for fun, and now I'm going to go to bed questioning myself.
What else can you do? You can learn to drive, James. That could be fun. You can go on road trips.
I mean, learning doesn't feel fun.
Why not? You learn new things about yourself.
Yeah, but I feel like that's a really long-term investment of fun.
Yeah, but you can go places after that. You can have potential other fun adventures. Also, mm-hmm. You're traveling, you can drive places, you could do road trips.
Yeah. So you're saying this is more of a long-term investment for future fun.
Yes.
Okay, so to confirm, we've got I can go bowling more often. I can wear shorts. I can join a dating app to pick up cougars, and I can get a driver's license.
I feel like this is not a fun list.
You're not the only one.
That's fun.
What's that?
Like swimming? Do you like going to the pool?
I don't know how to swim.
You could learn to swim.
Yeah, like, oh, guys, sorry, I can't hang out today. I've got driving lessons and swimming lessons. But I can wear a t-shirt and shorts later on.
It makes you feel better, James. I also don't know how to swim, and I still like going to the pool and the beach.
Okay, now what do you do at the pool? You hang out by the water on a towel?
I stand in the water. I just don't go in the deep end.
See, this is the other thing. I don't love summer too much. It's a little too hot for me. I don't like getting burnt or crispy.
Just wear sunscreen.
I feel like the best course of action is for me to just wait for my favorite time of year, the tail end of November, when my favorite thing in the whole wide world, Christmas, comes back and I can have fun again for a roughly 30 days.
Okay, wait, question. What about Christmas is fun for you?
I like the decoration. The music is fun. It feels festive and jolly. People go to parties. Food is exciting.
Okay, and
you get to give presents.
Your birthday's coming up. I mean, your birthday is like closer than Christmas, and you get to give presents. You can host a party.
Yeah, I've done that every year. I'm denouncing my own birthday party this year. Somebody wants to throw me a party, they can do that.
I'll throw you a party, James.
Great. Okay, what's the party going to look like? It'll be everyone wears shorts for James.
Actually, that would be fun. What if the theme was that everyone has to dress like you?
Yeah, I think that's a fun idea. And then maybe I'll be like, hey, Saima, who are all these old ladies that are here? And you're like, oh, these are just some people I met. I'd like to introduce you to Linda and Sheila and Kathleen and Carol.
And what's that activity old people
and like Gilda?
You can lawn bowl.
Keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth.
Lawn bowling, Saima. You're turning me into an old man here. Am I gonna go down to? I'm gonna go play lawn bowling in Westmount.
Maybe that's where you meet your cougars, or you can find a rich one too.
Yeah, cougars. Yeah, I feel like the closest thing to a cougar I'll be finding in a lawn bowling competition in Westmount is a taxidermied cougar.
Aha!
Well, Sim, I feel like we've really unlocked a lot of fun that I can be having.
One last idea, which I don't know if it appeals to you, would be karaoke.
Yeah, I don't mind karaoke. I feel like it's the COVID going around right now. I feel like it's not responsible to be playing. Maybe I'll get to the machine and I'll sing a song and everyone will be like, this guy's bringing down the fun with his sad classic rock.
For your birthday party, everyone will dress like you and we'll sing karaoke and we'll drink Cokes. How's that?
Well, it's okay if other people, you know, want to drink drinks. Raquel, she's invited. She can have another enormous glass of wine. Oh my God. Yeah. Okay. Well, I do feel like we've scratched the surface. Maybe we can try this again, Saima. And then when it's done, maybe the next time I'll feel a little bit better about myself.
I'm sorry. Did I make you feel bad?
No, I'm just teasing. I'm just teasing. I'm a very secure person. Well, Saima, I wish you the greatest of evenings as we begin to wind this thing down, and we'll get you back on this little itsy bitsy program soon.
Thanks for having me on, James. It's always fun.
The pleasure has been all mine. Thank you, Saima.
That was Saima Ahmed, superstar in the reggae. We're still having fun right now with the sex goblin himself, James McGee. Let's have some fun.
Yeah, let's have some fun. Folks, what an event this has been tonight. Again, if you tuned in, maybe a quarter of the way in, halfway in. Of course, you heard a lot of these sound effects, farts, sound clips, songs, stingers, all sorts of things. That's because these are the new Wednesdays on At Home with James. This is courtesy of DJ Dimitri Kyres. He's got someone in the booth working with him tonight named Ricky Tatziki. I think it's only fair if we check in as we begin to wind this thing down with the person who's been working the board this evening. So without any further ado, let's please welcome for the first time ever on At Home with James, it is Ricky Tatziki. Ricky, welcome aboard.
They hate me, patrolling and trying to catch me riding dirty. Trying to catch me riding dirty. Trying to catch me riding dirty.
Okay, so this is what I suspected. So there is no Ricky Tatziki.
There is no Ricky Tatziki, but I fooled you, didn't I?
I wanted to believe that there was another person, but I was 99% certain that the man behind coming up right now we've got was you.
That was me. Yeah, you want to see them side by side?
Do I want to see what side by side?
Characters, watch this.
You're listening to the highest internet radio station.
This is Ricky Zaziki coming at you live on At Home with James. We're getting sexed up and greased up. Every bit of our body is going to be explored with music. It's James McGee, the hottest thing since COVID-19. Let's go. It's James. James and more James. That's fun.
Yeah, okay, so it feels like, you know, your radio moniker, if that's what we want to call it, is an over-the-top party enthusiast Greek guy.
Yeah, Ricky Tzatziki. It's my my new persona for the Wednesday shows. You know, I tried something last week. I don't think it really batted 100, so to speak. So I'm
Why not?
It was a lot of fart noises.
Oh, and tonight wasn't?
I toned it back a little bit, 75%.
All right, so tonight's show has got 25% less farts.
25% less farts and a whole lot of music. So, you know,
I wanted to talk about the music, right? I feel like when people tune into the At Home show, like, let's think about a lot of the artists that we've talked about over the years on this show, right? Joni Mitchell has come up, Jim Croce, the Eagles, Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young. I don't feel like the music you've selected really fits the tone of the show.
And that's precisely the problem, okay? James, I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to be a little blunt with you right now.
I feel like people have been blunt with me all night long.
Fair. So there's a pattern, and I'm going to stick to it. There's five people watching right now, James, and we're not capitalizing.
Hold on. It's five people that we know who have accounts. The people that don't have accounts that are watching do not get accounted for.
And those people, who cares about them? They're too scared to even make an account to talk with us on the show.
You know, so you're right. Yeah, they could make an account and support so we would know what our target audience is. Maybe you're right.
Exactly. So if I, you know, God forbid, I came in here with some fresh ideas. Look, old Andy's gone. He forgot about us. He abandoned us. He's got better things to do.
Well, I don't know if that's the way I would word it.
It's true. All right? I'll word it that way. I know the guy. I love the guy. He's gone. He gave me the Wednesday time slot. And God dang it, I'm going to have the best time of my life. And I'm going to bring in some fresh Friday. Because I was the Friday guy, right?
Yep.
I was the Friday guy. I'm going
to bring... Yeah, I feel like a lot of this energy that you're bringing is better for Friday, right? You're trying to bring a party to a Wednesday night.
And what happened to the Friday shows, James? I got kicked off of those because I was too much of a vibes guy.
Oh, you never got kicked off of anything.
Yeah, you took me off the horse, and now here I am, a lone cowboy with only spurs to his name, and I'm trucking down this dusty road they call At Home with James. So what do you want me to do? I'm here. I got a fresh feel, all right?
Yeah, well, coming in from the chat right now, courtesy of... one of our newest but now quickly becoming legendary viewers from the real Andrew McKay writes, quote, love this fresh feel.
That's right. I love this fresh feel on a Wednesday.
I will tell you this much. If Saima gets her way and I'm romantic with another, I will not be having any fresh feels because the people that I'm with will be anything but fresh.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, boy, James. You see, this is the kind of stuff that I'm talking about. We got to get more fun in here. I need positive attitude.
All I was doing was affirming what Saima mentioned earlier.
And another thing, you got to quit bringing these guests on that are just burning you the whole time. As much as I love Saima, as much as I love Roque, listen, these are great people. These are world class.
Let me tell
you about these people. World class people. Let me tell you about these people. World class. But they're not cutting it, James. All right? You need to bring on some fresh people. Some fresh positive. We need to bring on a TikTok influencer.
Okay.
We need to bring on somebody who does YouTube videos out of an RV and makes quinoa. All right? We need somebody who does downhill skiing, some of the most gnarly, gnarly mountains on the planet. Positive thinking people. People with this kind of mindset.
Yeah, okay, so people that embody the energy of an air horn.
Yes, we need the air horn of a person that can come in here and they have a good, you know, good vibe to them. Positive for Wednesdays. You know what I mean? Am I out of line?
No, you're not out of line, right? Look, I think it's fair to say that...
because I love you.
I came into this show bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, and I feel like I've been obliterated as the night has gone on.
I don't know if it's just me, but it's this Ricky Tzatziki character is really taking a hold on me. You know what I mean?
No, I don't.
Well, I'm just saying that, you know, COVID-19 got me down. It got everybody down. But this Ricky Tzatziki guy, it's, I feel like a rocket ship. You know what a rocket ship does, James?
What's that?
Blasts off. Right into the sky. And I'm a shooting star. And you know the things about shooting stars, right? They just keep going higher and higher, James. And just like me and you, we're not going to stop at 5 people. We're going to go to 10. We're going
to 15. We're up to 6 now.
We're up. And why do you think that is? I'm not going to sit here. I'm going to tell you that the proof's in the pudding. The pudding's in front of you and you've gobbled it up. If you want more of this, I can do it, but I need your yay okay, because I can see you're uncomfortable. You've been uncomfortable all night.
Yeah, you know, you're right. You're right. There is a level of discomfort that comes along with it. But again, coming in from the chat, courtesy of Thomas Barnwell, he writes, the Wednesday shows have really come alive.
Barnwell is a great, great positive thinker. Mm-hmm. And I would love to see Barnwell on here start to, you know, get the energy back up.
And look, I love things that are alive. But if Saima had it her way, the people that I'll be dating will be close to no longer being alive.
Why do you talk that way? Why are you doing this to me?
I'm just trying to have fun with
some of the things. If I was a radio DJ, you just gave me dead air.
By talking?
With what you just said. I've got a pace going right now, and you just flatlined me. Now I gotta get the vibes back up.
Okay, so bring the vibes back up. Hit me with a stinger. Let people know what they're listening to.
All right.
Give me some of that Ricky Tzatziki.
You sure you want this?
Yeah, bring it alive, you know? If I'm the one bringing it down, why don't you bring it back up, Ricky?
Oh, boy. All right, you asked for it.
Welcome to the Cum Zone.
Oh, shit. Here we go again.
Oh, my God! Make that money!
I'm starting to understand where you're coming from now.
There we go. We're back. I feel good. Do you?
Yeah, I feel better than that guy from that sound clip. What's going on with that guy?
He was having a hard time. That guy was really going through it.
I relate to that guy right now. I relate to him. I feel like the show is like, you know, if we can be real for a second, it's like things might be falling apart a little bit, right? You know, every week that passes, I wonder, are we going to even have 3 shows this week? Or are we going to have 2? You know, am I letting things fall by the wayside?
No. Come on. I don't want you talking like that, James. What are you saying right now?
Well, you're coming around here, and I appreciate you're sprucing the place up. You're sprinkling some magic dust around, you know, and I just want you to know I appreciate it. And like you said, I am a little uncomfortable with it, but it's because, like I mentioned off the top, I'm so used to being in my comfort zone that maybe, you know, like I gotta change out of the shorts and I gotta get out of the hoodies and the Vans caps and things like that and embrace the new. Now, there's a comment coming in from the chat that I will not be repeating, but I would everyone's. Well, I don't like to be crass on the show.
Just say it, man.
I can't.
It's Wednesday. What'd you just say?
If anyone's going to say it, I think it's got to be you.
James needs to get in the cum zone. There, I said it. And I'm the bastard, and I'm really the naughty Nancy right now.
No one's calling you. No one's calling you the B word. No one's calling you a naughty Nancy. I just think that maybe these types of words are more suited for this devil may care attitude and energy that you
got. My God, are you still talking?
Yeah, I had to pull that one out. And I wasn't gonna do it tonight. I've heard you say time and time again, James. Time and time again how this might be it. We might not do this show anymore. We might go to 1 day a week. We might go to 2 days a week. We might not do the show anymore. Only 5 people are watching tonight. I don't even know them. They don't have accounts. 6. Same amount of the people at your birthday. Yeah. What I'm trying to say, James, is we need to change it up because we don't got forever. And if we don't do it now, then that's it. We're never gonna change, James. So it's either you lay it on the line right now. We don't do a show on Wednesday. Or we don't do a show on Wednesday, or we come back harder next week. And I'm going to let you think about it. And if we don't come back to the show next week, if there is no Wednesday show next week, then I have your answer.
Baba Booey.
Sorry, I got a little dim in here. I needed it to bring me back up.
Look, you know, this is, I really feel that, you know, this show, we've prided ourselves on being open and honest on this thing. And I think that, you know, if you're going to be open and honest, I have to do the same, not only to you and the people watching, but myself as well. And,
come on,
you know, maybe it's time for a change. You know, maybe I need to embrace the change and walk away from what we've been doing and start to really achieve the heights and explore the stars.
What are you saying right now? I need you to speak it plain to me because I don't understand.
I felt like that was pretty plain.
Are you canceling the show?
No, I'm saying that I'm going to embrace this new vision where we turn things upside down. Maybe it's time to shake things up in here like you've been doing. Give me a sound effect.
Are you kidding me right now?
Give me one right now.
Are you serious?
Give it to me.
All right. Short version of that song.
Yeah, that was a very short version. Well, look, Dimitri, you've given me a lot of food for thought. I want to thank you so much for all the help tonight. Let's have a team meeting this weekend. Let's put some plans in place.
I knew, and you know what? I set that all up. I knew you weren't gonna do it, James. I teed you up to really, you know, you could have packed it up. You could have left the show.
You're right.
But you didn't. And you know what? That's why I love you very much.
Dimitri, I love you too, and I want to thank you for pushing me out of my comfort zone. I mean, who knows what's next for me, right? Who knows?
I don't know. Only you got the hand on the steering wheel, and that pages that you're reading from that book that are empty, they're yours to write. And with that, James, I'm out of here. This has been Ricky Tzatziki playing the hits and playing nothing but the hits. Live. All right, well, everybody, let's get down tonight, and this is James McGee signing you off. I've had a pleasure and nothing but love. Let's party and let's go. Welcome to the rest of your life.
All right, well, that was DJ Dimitri Kyres, a.k.a. for One Night Only, Ricky Tzatziki. Folks, that's our show. We've done it. How do I feel tonight? After all has been said and done, the smoke has cleared and the dust has settled. Worse about myself than I did prior to tonight's broadcast. But the fact that the people, no matter how many you are out there across the internet on twitch.tv/athomewithjames are watching, I appreciate you. Or as I like to say, I appreciate you. Folks, I want to thank Racquel Belmonte, Saima Ahmed, Dimitri Kyres for being here. We will be back on Monday. Who's going to be here? Of course, the one and only Dave Kaufman back in the saddle again. Until then, I am James. You are you. We are here. Good night, goodbye, farewell, and be well.
Welcome to my house. Baby, take control now. We can't even scroll now. We don't have to go out. Welcome.